Steve Dotto here. Hope you are well. We have a great productivity feature for you today. We're going to look at the task timer 3030. Now, this is not a to-do list manager. 3030 is a task timer. And the philosophy is that we need to spend time concentrating on our tasks. And in this world of being always connected and having your computer and different distractions, phone and everything coming in at you at all times, it always breaks our distraction, all these things. And I am one of the worst offenders. I am like a magpie. Any bright and shiny object attracts me instantly. So the minute Apple Notifier tells me that there's an email or a tweet about me, I immediately look at it and start poking around and playing with it. And I lose concentration. I lose momentum on whatever task I'm working on. And this costs me a lot of time and productivity, or it did cost me a lot of time. I've worked my way around that by installing 3030. Now, unfortunately, 3030 only works on iOS devices. It's only for Mac or for your iPhone or your iPad. But really, the philosophy kind of follows the same philosophy as these guys here with the Pomodoro technique. The Pomodoro technique is all about letting fruit determine your day. I think it's kind of silly. What it is they've got this silly timer. I say silly, and I apologize if I'm offending any Pomodoro aficionados. But basically, the idea is we concentrate on a single task, and they are right about this. Is that a tomato or an apple? I guess it looks like a tomato. It's a tomato. I thought it was an apple. But at any rate, it's a piece of fruit. It's vegetable fruit. What it does is it's a timer, and in using this technique, people say, I'm going to concentrate on one task for 25 minutes, and then I'm going to give myself a break, a little reward. But if we stay concentrated on a task for 25 minutes, we reach maximum productivity because concentration has momentum built into it. And every time we break our concentration, we go back to first gear and we kind of have to start going again. We've all experienced being in that zone where we just get so much work done. That's because we've reached our maximum productivity level and we're really concentrating and focused and we're able to move ahead. So they've got this tomato timer that you basically spin to 25 minutes and then you stay focused on a task and you do it with paper and you say, I'm going to do this task and then I'm going to give myself a break. I'm going to do this task. I'm going to do myself a break. I don't want to let a piece of fruit or vegetable or whatever you want to call it, tomato, run my life. I'd rather have a piece of technology run my life. So 3030 is my answer to that. Now 3030, let's jump into it here. Now, 3030 is a free app, costs nothing to use, but as I mentioned, is only available in iOS at this point. Encourage them by all means for the other platforms because it's well worth it. So it's a task timer, not a task list manager or a calendar appointment manager. So when we put in assignments, when we put in tasks to do here, it's not saying that at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I need to do this task, make this phone call. Instead, it's I've got this that I want to work on. I want to work on my email. I want to work on writing my book. I want to work on this task, and I want to spend this much time on it. And it allows us to stay focused on the task for that period of time. It basically counts us down and times us. And what it does is it holds us accountable so that when a distraction comes in, when a notifier says that there's an interesting tweet that you might want to take a look at, instead of breaking away from what you're doing because you happen to catch that in the corner of your eye, you look at the timer and you go, oh, I've got 29 minutes left on this task. I can stay on that for that time because you don't want to disappoint yourself. It's kind of like a personal trainer for technology. You know how the trainer makes you do those 3 extra sit-ups that you maybe don't want to do? This allows you to stay focused on the task that you've assigned to yourself already beforehand and tells you when you've done the appropriate amount of time. And what it does, if you start to use it on a regular basis, is it allows you to do all of the baseline things that you know is important to your job. Be it if you're a salesperson doing 20 minutes or 30 minutes of cold calling a day. If you're a writer, having that focused of, just sitting there writing for 45 minutes uninterrupted. If it allows you to do those things that are difficult to do because they're the hard work part of your job that it distractions come into easily because really in some ways you want to be distracted because you want to be taken away from it. At least that's the way I find it. Let me show you quickly the interface. It's dead simple. It's a beautiful, simple interface. There's a timer here at the very top of the screen that you see. Now they've added some new features to this, the latest release since we last looked at it. They've added a little checklist thing here, which will move the whatever you're working on down to the bottom. There's a done marker, which is clicks it is done, and you can add or subtract time or trash the task. So you've got some nice interface options right there within the screen itself. If I tap on the settings, you can go in, and this allows you to do global settings, including, you know, showing more information or even sharing this with other people. The stay on is important if you want to always have the timer showing in the corner. For instance, I keep mine on a stand. I keep my iPad on a stand, and since it's plugged in, I can leave it on, and it doesn't affect my battery life. So the timer is always there, and it's not just beeping when I'm done. I can actually look over and see how much time I have left. So I like to have that particular feature added to it as well, which is a good thing. Now, how we go about actually setting our tasks is, and you can do it by the day. You can give the tasks different names. I like to go by the day that I'm working on, because I typically set my tasks the evening before when I'm full of vim and vinegar as far as what tomorrow may bring. And I say, I want to get this accomplished and this accomplished and this accomplished tomorrow. So I put them in, and sometimes I give myself a little more than I can handle. But I've got that list now that I want to attack because I don't want to disappoint myself. To add something new to the list, let's say I want to add some website maintenance. I want us to do a half an hour website maintenance. I just pinch between any two of them and spread my fingers apart, and that opens up a new label. So I'll just go site maintenance. I'll just say site main so we know exactly what I mean. You put in how much time you want, and I want to spend 20 minutes on the site. And then you can add a graphic to it. Let me open it up again. Where is it? There it is. Let me open it up. You can add a graphic, and they've got some nice, simple, basic graphics. What would I use for that? Probably computer time. Put on the computer logo, and you can also color code it. Now it's set in, and then you can adjust where it is in your day, where it is in your list, just by tapping on it and dragging it one way or the other. When you're ready to start work, you hit the timer, and it starts to count down. It is as simple as that. And if it seems overly simple, that's because it really is. I mean, but the fact that it's down there with the word of what you're planning on doing, with you set intent by putting it on the page here, means that you tend to stay focused on task. It's actually quite good. It's way better than trying to use a stopwatch or something like that. It may even be better than using a ticking tomato. I'm not sure. But for me, it really, really works well. I am, as you can tell, I'm pretty excited about what this, what extra level of productivity this can bring to your day. I hope you have found this video useful. If you have, please give us a like. We certainly appreciate credit for the work that we do. We will see you again soon. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.